All right, you guys, God bless you and welcome to This Is It 4321 Before the Fire. His purpose was to make one new man from the two, thus making peace. How does he do that? He inverts the upside down you, and the two become one. The upside down you gets inverted and then superimposed on the right side up you, and the two become one in Christ. You're literally inverted and superimposed on Christ. Wait till you see what I'm going to show you in this video. In the most crazy way, I'm going to show you a little video that I stitched together today with Dave the Wave, but then I'm going to comment on all the things that happened because of stitching this video together. Yesterday I showed to you, I didn't show you my opinion, I didn't show you what I think. I communicated to you what the Lord God, the creator of all things, has communicated to me, that the bombings that are printed on the U.S. currency, there's the Pentagon bombing. I mean, if you can't see it, I'm sorry that you're just incapable of seeing what's right in front of your face. There's a Pentagon bombing. There's a Twin Tower bombing. The federal building bombing. And bombings that are coming are printed on these U.S. currency notes. I showed you in the video yesterday. Okay. Within the last 24 hours, the Lord has confirmed again on steroids that this is about to happen. If you want to see how he confirmed that, watch this video. Okay, now I'm going to give you a quick like preview of what's coming. So I ended up with a 1965 fastback Mustang. Mike, who is at the get-together, without giving you the whole backstory, Mike gave it to us. I did some work on it. I got it up and running. I gave it to one of my kids, and I gave some money to the ARC. My son called me the other day. He said, hey, Dad, this car is like too much for me. Would you be okay if I sold it? And I said, you know what? I'll tell you what. I'll take the car from you, and I'll give you a little money down, and that way you're not pressed to sell it, and no one tries to scam you. And when and if I sell it, I'll just give you the money from that. So that was our deal. So let me ask you this. How crazy, how mind-boggling, how inconceivable is it that after I did the video yesterday where I showed you what's coming is printed on the $100 bill. Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem, a prophetic utterance that the Lord gave me, is that those words are printed on the $10 bill. There's water as high as the walls of Jerusalem, a seven-story building. How mind-boggling is it that right now I'm about to show you documented proof that yesterday I ended up with a white Mustang that the owner called it the White Horse. It was given back to me by my son Steven because he said it was just too much car for him and he would rather have some money to go to school. And I said, I totally understand that. But think about this. Stephen means crowned. The name of the car was, it's a white 65 Mustang fastback. Mike, who owned it, literally named it the White Horse. And now I have the White Horse sitting in my driveway in front of a house that's got Jesus's name written in three head symbols in the same orientation as the crosses at Calvary. I don't even know how to process that to be, you know, someone mentioned in a video, don't say insane, Click. You shouldn't do that. Why? It's insane. It's beyond my brain. It's almost inconceivable. So right now, I'm going to show you documentation that right now, the Lord has communicated not once, not twice, but again and again and again within the last 24 hours. Prepare your hearts. Here it comes. I'm just telling you. I'm going to play the video for you. Then I'm going to show you how the Lord communicated. I'm going to play this little video, and I'm going to let you watch the whole thing. And then I'm going to go back, and I'm going to show you how the Lord communicated to me that the get-together at the Ark was the culmination of the night I got saved until the end of what's coming, to show me a juxtaposition so you guys could understand. Like the night I got saved, I opened a door to pure freedom. The night I got saved, when I pushed that door open, And I walked out that door and I prayed and I received Christ in that alley, standing there with Michael with water and light coming down on me. I was in a totally different world. I mean, everything changed. When I was at the Ark for this get together and that little door in the back of that shipping container opened, isn't it insane that, I mean, don't say insane, Clark, isn't it insane or beyond the human brain that the whole crowd was misted with this light mist rain? And you're going to see it in this video. It was like the night, I even mentioned that when I was there, like the night I got saved, there was this mist. And it was just like what happened at the Ark. Yeah, I got moistened, but it didn't rain hard on me. It just kind of misted, drizzled on me, and then it was gone. I mean, what I'm going to show you is just almost unbelievable, but thank God I document everything. So without talking anymore, watch the video. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back and I'm going to show you how the Lord used even the production of this video again, to show me it's time for a new beginning. He gave me a scripture today during the production of this video that proves that we are inverted to and converted and we are superimposed over Christ, and that the entire experience I had in that alley was to show me a juxtaposition of what happened at the Ark with the big get together with everybody. Basically, I was a precursor 20 years in front of what the Ark represented when that back door opened up. And you'll see what I mean once we do it. Let's just get to it. Pay attention to the video I'm going to play now. And then I have about 15 windows, and we have 30, 40 minutes of images to go over that are just going to blow your mind. Go get your spatula, get a cup of coffee, get ready. This is so exciting. This is guaranteed. I mean, what I mean by guaranteed is this communication is absolutely, absolutely guaranteed that the Lord wants me to know this. He wants you to know it. Don't forget, I am Yahweh has given. That's my name. That's what Jonathan means. Collect means a messenger that rings a bell, gathers the church. Okay, y'all ready? Are y'all excited? I'm freaking out. I'm like, okay, it's about to happen. Oh my gosh. Okay. I need just so crazy. Okay, I want to pay attention to all the little details. Calm down, Johnny. Here we go. Y'all ready? I'm going to play this first video and then we'll take it from there. Here we go. Oh, by the way, the globalists proclaim transhumanism will eliminate free will as if it's a good thing. So they are that's happened today. They're coming out saying, oh, we're going to eliminate free will and the need for your soul. It's like, okay, sounds great. Anyway, here we go. Y'all ready? Let's do this. Here's the video for today. Hang on one sec. Okay.
And so,
here we go. Okay, here begins the video. I am right there where this thing starts. I am picking up the car from my son, Stephen. Don't forget, Stephen means crowned. I'm driving off in this vehicle that was named the White Horse. It's a 1965 white Mustang. And by a bizarre set of circumstances, I just ended up with it. I didn't really want it at all. That's why I said to my son, if you want it, I'll get it running and I'll give it to you and you can have it if you want it. And he was like, oh, yeah, yeah. Now he doesn't want it. So yesterday I was bringing the car home and I was just going over in my mind the spiritual significance, how just mind-boggling. So, you know, the Bible says, and he was given a crown. Stephen means crowned. He was given a crown. And behold, a white horse. He went out conquering and to conquer on a white horse. And yesterday, Stephen handed over a white horse, and it's sitting in front of my house, which has Jesus' name on my house in hat symbols. After I just did the video where I showed you guys, this is what the Lord showed me is coming, going out to conquering and to conquer. Do you even think that's even remotely possible? It's not even remotely possible, but okay. Now I'm just going to shut up and here we go. Okay, let's do it. Okay, here we go.
So, making a quick video. I'm in a white Mustang Fastback 1965. Mike had it. He donated it to the ARC. I went ahead and fixed it up and gave the ARC some money for it. I ended up with this vehicle today. My son, who I actually bought it for, when I say bought it, I gave the ARC money for it, and I let my son have it, but it's too much of a vehicle for him. So oddly enough, today I'm getting back the white horse. Steven, my son, the name Steven means crowned. It's kind of interesting. The Bible says, and he was given a crown and he went out conquering and to conquer. Steven means crown. He went out on a white horse conquering and to conquer. I mean, the symbology is just crazy. I mean, even the name of this car, Steve called it the white horse. I find that fascinating. There we go. I'm going to get it. So anyway, I'm just going to document this. This is pretty wild. Right now I'm driving a white Mustang. Without getting into all the backstories, I gave this car to my son. It fell into my lap. I fixed it up, got it running. It was too much vehicle for my son. So it's pretty fascinating. He called me yesterday, a couple days ago, and I told him, yeah, I'll take it back. It's just too much vehicle for him. And he's just got some other plans in his life, and this vehicle doesn't fit with it. Anyway, so isn't it odd I posted the video yesterday, and today I'm driving a white horse, and my son's name is Stephen, which means crowned. The Bible says he went out conquering and to conquer, and to him was given a crown, and he went out conquering and to conquer on a white horse. What's really strange is this vehicle, the guy that Mike, well, the guy that was at the get-together that had the trailer and the tractor that was helping us spread the dirt, Mike is the one where this vehicle came from, and he named this car the White Horse. Yeah, it's crazy that I'm driving a White Horse today. I got it from Steven, and yesterday I posted the video. I posted literally last night at like 3 in the morning. So I think it's interesting. There's the white horse. Right behind me is Theory Coffee. I'm gonna show you the front of Theory Coffee in just a sec. One eye's up, one eye's down. Once you know the system, it's inescapable, you know it. I showed it to you in Calvin and Hobbes yesterday. Anyway, what are the odds that today I'm driving the white horse and I got it from Stephen, and Stephen means crown, and he was given a crown and he went out conquering into conquer on a white horse. I think the time is here, guys. I know it's here because of the video I posted yesterday. There you go. There it is. That says it all. It's not a theory anymore. It's a fact. Okay, so now I want to talk about just the spiritual significance of this car. Mike called it, he named it the White Horse, I guess, decades ago. It's parked in front of a house that's got the three het symbols on it and the same orientation as the crosses in Calgary. There's 1, 2, 3. That one, and then the other one together is 888, which means Jesus our Savior, Jesus the Savior. So a house that has his name on it now has a white horse. I mean, I don't even know what to do with that significantly on a spiritual level. That's crazy. So now when you look at this, the whole setup, I mean, this is just mind-boggling, the reality of some of the stuff. There's There's Het, 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 888. There's a white horse sitting in front of it. And I'm...
I just want to pause it for a sec. I know during this video, even before I started, I said, you know, Stephen means crown and white horse, white horse. Mike named that car 20 years ago, I guess, the white horse. And it's sitting in my driveway in front of three Het symbols. For the people that have been around for a while, y'all know that this house, the spiritual symbology of the house that I'm in, that the house that the Harbinger in the end of the world would literally have Jesus's name on it in Het symbols. And now there's a white horse in the driveway, metaphorically speaking. I that's just beyond my brain. That makes the rock in the canyon look like nothing. That's just mind boggling. Anyway, I'm just like, okay, now listen. After you watch this, I'm going to show you, this is not just the one confirmation. You're going to see confirmation after confirmation after confirmation that you better believe I am ringing the bell and showing you what is coming right away. My birthday is March 16th, guys. I know that in the Bible, and I don't do dates, but it is kind of interesting in the Bible. Several of God's servants have been born and expired on the same day. I would not be surprised if this ends by my birthday. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised. I wouldn't be surprised if it ends tomorrow, because the stage is set. We have the plandemic. All the rats, like Hillary Clinton and all of them, they're all being caught. The news is out that you know they've been scamming all of us. The Vatican's a snake. All of this hidden stuff, the veil has been torn open. The word apocalypse means the unveiling. That's all I've been doing, guys, is unveiling all of it. So I want you to watch the spiritual symbology and what I'm about to let you finish watching. Then I'm going to open the folders, the ark folder, and show you the way the Lord rolled out the spiritual meaning of what's about to happen and just let you see it for yourself. So anyway, let's just keep going, okay? Freak out.
And I just happened to be the harbinger that would ring the bell that the end of the world's here, I guess. This is hard to believe. It's mind-boggling.
I'm going to pause it for a minute because I want you guys to understand what you're seeing right now. This is the spiritual supernatural symbology that has followed me. I mean, everything. I mean, even the stuff you see up there, the sky surfing with the space shuttle, Discovery. I mean, really? So I look like I'm crucified and I'm sky surfing with the Discovery behind me. You know, after the Lord, after I was falling out of the sky upside down with things on to show, you know, like a juxtaposition of us falling into the cannibalistic system and then discovering the truth. And I look like I'm crucified. The Bible says I have been crucified with Christ. It is not me that lives, but Christ lives in me. So see, the Lord drew out a physical manifestation in the very fabric of my life and the things I did that would spell out this incredible tapestry of absolute mind-boggling truth. 100% nylon. It's, if you nylon had a twin word, it would be no lion. Do you understand now? I mean, my mind is blown. Just wait, guys. There's a lot more. So, okay, the white horse is in the driveway in front of a house that has three head symbols that are in the same orientation as the crucifixion of Christ with Jesmus and Decimus. Representing Christ in the middle, reconciling the twin system. See, we're in a twin system, and that's what gets reconciled. One gets turned up and then gets superimposed over Christ. So the evil one gets turned up and the two become one in Christ. Do you get it? We get superimposed. Watch. Let me just show you an example. I really like this because Jesus was crucified right side up. Peter was crucified upside down. And in order to make that system one, it's a set of twins. See it? One's right side up, one's upside down. But when you invert one, then the two come together. You superimpose one on top of the other, and then the two become one in Christ instead of a twin system in opposition to itself. This is the mystery of everything, you guys. I mean, of the entire world, of the universe, of our being, of the origins of all of us, and the end of everything, and the beginning of something new. This is the understanding of all of it. And just to prove the Lord has a sense of humor, he let a miscreant like Jonathan Kleck deliver this to you? He's got a sense of humor. I'm serious. He's got to. Okay, here we go. Oh, yes. I thought I'd keep an eye on that. Okay, here we go. Look, behold, a virgin shall be with child, and she shall bring forth a son. They shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is with us is El, the Almighty God. And look right here. Scripture teaches that the name Jesus is the only name under heaven whereby men must be saved. And here is Jesus in Greek. Look, 888. So this right here, 888 right there, you see that 888? This is a head symbol. This is the number 8 in the Jewish alphabet. Het is 888. And it's in the same orientation of the crosses where Christ crucified in the middle and Jesmus and Decimus on the side. And it's on my house and now there's a white horse in the driveway. I mean, what? So I hope you understand just how insanely impossible this is. Okay, I'm going to slow down, take another deep breath. Let's keep going. Okay, I just wanted to explain so you understand. Even the 8 and the 2 and the 2 on my house, the Lord told me to look them up. 8 means regeneration and rebirth. And 22 is L is my father. Just watch this slideshow again very slowly and read it. Pause on anything that's written. Watch this slideshow more than once. Just pause it and read it until you understand it. This is the making of world history right now, guys. This video and the understanding of what this is, this will ring in the halls of eternity. Okay, here we go. Let's do it. Okay, I want to pause the slideshow there for a minute so you understand what the symbology is. You're right. Look, before I got converted and I owned Vlad Eyewear vampire sunglasses, I mean, I was a perfect example of someone that was of the world, in the world, loved the world, in the world, and it was my little vampire party going on, which is really the truth of everybody that's here. You just don't know it. So the Lord made sure I was a skydiver. He made sure I had a vision company come out of the darkness into the light with Vlad Eyewear, because our sunglasses are so good. Even if you're a vampire, you can come out during the day and play and have fun with me and all the girls and party. Okay, do you get it? So the Lord even made sure I had a vision company. And the Lord's ministry, Jesus, he said his ministry was to restore the sight to the blind. Well, vampires can't come out during the daylight. They have to be converted or something. So we're going back the other way. Now watch. So come out of the darkness, and I'm falling out of the sky upside down, representing the fall of the angels to the earth. Come out of the darkness and then into the light. And then I look like I'm crucified with Christ, sky, like I'm crucified, sky surfing with the discovery behind me. That's impossible. The only reason I'm on that load is because that skydiving load was because a friend of mine that was a doctor, I trained him how to sky surf. His name was Dr. Les King. He called me up. He's like, "Hey, Johnny, I got you on the shuttle load." I'm like, "Dude, step away from the anesthesia, Les. What are you talking about?" He said, "No, man, I got you a ticket. We're going to be in an airplane at 15,000 feet while the Discovery is launching. And as soon as it launches, we're going to sky surf with the space shuttle." And I was like, "Shut the F up." He's like, "Dude, just get out to Florida. There it is. You're looking at it. That's a four-panel poster of the day. Space Shuttle Shuttle Discovery, Kennedy Space Center, August 10th, 2001. That's right before I got saved. A year before I got saved. So the Lord set me up to do what I'm doing for y'all now. Do you understand? That's why I'm Yahweh is given. He made sure that every facet of my life was a biblical intersection so I could understand all this. Because no one could have ever understood this. You had to live it out. I mean, there had to be all this evidence for one person to wrap their brain around this, because it's so mind-boggling. Okay, now, take a deep breath. I just wanted to make sure I explain these things as they go along. Come out of the darkness, because you're in a cannibalistic, vampiric system. Come out of the darkness into the light. So let's see, Johnny, representation of the darkness. Here we go. So there it is, falling from, like, think about this. Think about falling from heaven into a vampiric system. There I am, falling with fangs on into the system. And then it shows me and into the light, because your vision's restored. Do you get it? This is beyond impossible, guys. This is a complete setup by the Lord God, the creator of all things. Okay, here we go. Ready? Okay, I'm going to pause it at this point of the video too. That's the St. Anthony Hotel where I got saved. Guys, I never even really considered, never thought about it. Someone said, "Hey, have you ever looked up the name Anthony?" Usually I'll hear the Lord tell me to do something and I'll do it. Let me show you something real quick. Let me see if I can pause this. Okay, watch this. Okay, ready? The meaning of the name Anthony, priceless one. Do you know why? Because what he gave me is priceless. At the get together at the Ark, I took my federal lawsuit and I left it there. I was like, if anybody wants to see it, it was a $375 million lawsuit I was in. And I walked away from everything, guys. I was willing to walk away from that kind of money. I mean, I could have gone out and redone my sunglassing if that's all I wanted to do. I'd already done it once. And then just because I went through a very difficult time and, you know, with Lou and the whole thing, doesn't mean I couldn't just go redo it. But the Lord had me turn away from all of it. And then when I was betrayed by my own wife, he said, "Okay, do I have your attention now?" And I was like, "Yes, you got my undivided attention." So anyway, this whole thing's an incredible testimony to what the Lord God orchestrated. nothing for me. I don't, in no way, shape, or form, I don't want any accolades. I want you to give glory to God. The Lord God set me up so I could help you guys. And I'm all in. I'm all in. That's all I want to do, is help everybody get out of here. That's my goal, is to help you get out of here. Okay, but look at this. So even that. So let's go back to the, saying that, look what it is too. It's one V and another V intersecting. How many times? His purpose was to make one new man from the two, thus making peace. You couldn't even think this up. You couldn't even imagine, you couldn't write the movie script to this. Even if you were the most brilliant movie script writer ever, you couldn't do this. Okay, watch. Let's keep going. Okay, let me do this. I'll enlarge it. Let's play it. Okay, you know what? I know I just keep stopping and going, but guys, when I walked out of that alley, right after I got saved, praying with an angel, our Father who art in heaven, water and light comes down on me, and I am just filled with the Holy Spirit, just beaming, and then people have, you know, tried to come, oh, click, no, oh, you, God would never have you say Hail Mary. You wanna bet? Because he had me do it. You know why? Because when you turn the image of the virgin the other direction, it's a dead sheep. Isn't it crazy? I put my testimony on YouTube so long ago, and I said, after I prayed Our Father and water and light came down on me, I was beaming, glowing, and the Holy Spirit was just exuding out of me. And then Michael looks at me and says, now you say a Hail Mary. And even though I would have no reason to ever believe that that was wrong, I would never have a reason to believe that was wrong because I was raised Catholic. When he told me to do it, I looked at him like, why? I knew it was wrong somehow. And then as I said the words, I felt life and light leaving my body. That's so I would understand where death came from, the virgin. What happened now with the Catholic Church? Oh, it's a big snake. Who do they worship? The Virgin. So I guess my testimony stands, doesn't it? Because there are a lot of naysayers. Oh, Cliff, you liar. I'm like, you know what? Y'all are in deep trouble. Bad, deep trouble. Okay, here we go. Okay, now I'm just going to stop commenting. I'm just freaking out right now. Guys, you don't understand. For me, this is actualization. I am being actualized. My entire ministry from the day one, I'm like, oh my gosh, the end is here now. It's literally about to happen. And he's given me proof. And I got a white horse in the driveway in front of his name on a house. Okay, gotta calm down. Let's try it again. Okay, I'm gonna try and let the video just play for a while, and then I'll go back and comment. But guys, we've got another hour and a half of freaking out. Here you go. The king's coming. Jesus is coming. The end of the world is here. Okay. Here we go. That's what I walked into when I walked out of the alley. It's Adam in the Garden of Eden right here. It's Adam and then Christ ascending into heaven. Get it? Adam in the garden, Christ ascending. From the first to the last, the beginning and the end. And we just had a get together at the ark where there's an open door on the back of the container that's the bride, and the exit sign's been turned right side up. And the night I got saved, I had to walk out a door in the back of that hotel facing guaranteed death. If I opened that door, I would be probably killed by the guys I was in a high-speed chase with that day. But I was willing to open the door and die to know the truth, while Eleuthera, which means licentious freedom, was trying to stop me from opening that door. Don't open the door, Jonathan. You will get killed. I'm like, you don't have to go. I have to go. Jonathan opened the door. I pushed the door open. I walked out, started walking horizontally. Those stairs turned to a ramp. Boom, hit the ground. Michael steps up and says, pray with me, my brother. We prayed, Our Father who art in heaven. Water and light came down on me. I was glowing, filled with the Holy Spirit. The light had come in me. I was moistened. It was like dew all over me. I was anointed. And then he steps away and says, now you say a Hail Mary, even though I had no reason to know that was wrong inherently because of the new spirit that was in me. Somehow I was like, okay. And he just said, do it. And I said those words. I felt life and light leaving my body, because that's what takes the life and light out of your body, is the worship of the Virgin, the willingness to come in here and fornicate with the daughters of men. Now the picture is perfect. Wow. Okay. And when I walked out of that alley and I saw that Jesus ascending into heaven, Adam in the garden, I had no idea I'd be sitting here 20 years later giving a testimony to the end is here now. And right underneath that whole lit up image of the stained glass was a guy scattering seed and said, whatsoever a man soweth, that must he also reap. Isn't it crazy? And it was in Peacock Alley. I don't know if you know the symbology of a peacock, but in Christianity, it represents eternal life. Okay, now let's calm down and drink some more coffee. Here we go. I'm going to pause it right there. Okay, that was my idol right there, Eleuthera. The Bible says, in the Bible, in Romans, and those of us that have been adopted have been given the glorious liberty of the sons of God. Do you know what the word liberty is? It's Eleutheria. That's her name. You know what Eleutheria means? It means licentious or legitimate freedom. You can choose. What do you think I chose to be in this earth? It's odd that I have a girlfriend named Eleuthera. Do you think that's even possible? And Eleuthera was trying to stop me from opening the door so I would go out and get converted. Do you know what the word in the Bible says? You will know the truth and the truth will set you free. You know what the word free is? Eleuthero. Whoa, you know why? Because it's male. It's the male form of Eleuthera. Eleuthera is female. Eleuthero is male. Eleuthera means licentious or legitimate freedom. Eleuthero means freedom. So I left Eleuthera behind. I opened the door up. I was willing to die to know the truth, to know Christ. I didn't know it meant to know Christ. I just knew I wanted to know the truth, and I was willing to die to get to it. And I opened the door and I got saved in that alley. And I'm here to tell you, after I was lit up and filled with the Holy Spirit, and then I said the Hail Mary and I felt life and light leaving my body. I was like, what? And then Michael looked at me and he said, you look like you need some water. You should go to the bus station and get some water. And I just went, I'll go to the bus station and get some water. And then I started walking. Lou had disappeared from my hemisphere. I didn't even know she was with me at that point. And as I was walking, she touched my shoulder, my right shoulder. I felt her touch. And I went like this, and I pulled my shoulder away from her. And I looked back at her, and I said, don't touch me. I'm walking with the Lord. Don't touch me. I'm walking with the Lord. Don't touch me. That's all I wanted her to do before I got saved. It's like, why in the world would I be, don't touch me? Because that was the thing that got us all in trouble. Do you see how everything's absolute perfection? Even the name of my girlfriend at the time? Well, Clark, you're a false prophet. No, you're in deep, 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 deep shit if you call me a false prophet. Okay, now, let's keep going. I'm freaking out right now. Here we go. Let's do it. There's Eleuthera. Now, look what it says right here. Rise with the sun. Look. Rise with the sun. S-O-N. See it? I made the letter O, the sun in the sky, not, okay, like, because, but, you know, S-U-N would be the sun in the sky, but I made it an O because the sun in the sky is round, and it went with the whole vampire thing. Get it? Rise with the sun. But look, it's right side up, upside down. This is mind-boggling, you guys. Freak out. Here we go. Let's continue. So I got to, you know what? Here's what I'm going to do, guys. I'm going to comment during this whole slideshow and show you what everything means. That way you walk away from this with everything. And then I'll play the whole slideshow over again. But watch this. Here is Romans right here. You ready? Ready? Watch. For the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption to the glorious liberty. Look, 1657. See it right here? What does it say? Eleuthera. Freedom, legitimate or licentious, right? So we shall be transformed, delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. Because the children of God, you have liberty to choose either licentious or legitimate freedom. But down here it says, and not only they, but ourselves also, we have the first fruits of the Spirit, capital S. Even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption to it, the redemption of our body. See it? See Eleuthera? Licentious or legitimate freedom. Let's go back one picture. Sorry, it was right there somewhere. I'm sorry, guys. Hang on one sec. Okay, sorry, there you go, right here, there it is. So there's Eleuthera, and Eleuthera was trying to stop me from opening the door. Can you imagine? Can you imagine that this is all real? That this is, I mean, can you imagine the detail you're looking at right now? And there's a white horse in my driveway. You know, metaphorically speaking, a car called the White Horse, and it's a white Mustang that I just got back yesterday. Because by no choice of, you know, it wasn't my idea. It was just, it happened that way. Okay, let's keep going. Ready? I'm gonna pause it right there. This is the actual door that I had to go out the night I got saved. You see it right there? Stop. Alarm will sound. I had to make the choice to open that door, light up the whole hotel with a fire alarm going out the fire exit. That would have lit up the whole place going woo, woo. And you know what? Nothing happened. I opened the door, there was no noise, nothing. And I walked out that door. I started walking along this horizontal set of, it was a walkway, and it just went boom. It turned to a staircase. I sat down on the ground. Michael's standing right there. Pray with me, my brother. Do you believe me now? Okay, that was the door I was faced with the night I got saved. There it is. It's all in the video. Here we go. I'm going to comment on this right now. You see that doorway right there? Okay, think about this. I had to come out a doorway. I want to make something very clear though. You see this doorway right here? There's another doorway right up above it. This doorway was open the day I went down to the alley, so I photographed it. The doorway I came out of was right up here above it. I walked down these stairs, and then as I started walking horizontally, these stairs right here went to a 45 degree angle and I went down. This door is not the same as the door above it. This door, but I had to use it for the photograph, you know, so to give you guys the idea. Okay, now just stop and think about everything I told you. Do you think any of this is remotely even possible? Now think about this. The night I got saved, I had to open a door that meant imminent death. I was willing to die to know the truth. At the get together at the Ark, by just an organic set of circumstances, the Lord told me to take out the mirror that was in that one shipping container of the bride. He had told me to put the mirror in there for Grand Junction, but then he told me to take the mirror out. Now, at the Ark, the mirror came out and that exposed the rear door. The rear door had a key in it. A door from the inside should just have a little thing you twist, like a little, you know, bolt on it. It had a key in it. because you have to have the key from the inside, just like us. Do you get it? So he gave me the key, and then the exit sign that was turned upside down and mounted by the electrician, Victor, it was not really fixable without taking the whole wall down. So then when we took the mirror out and the other wall part of the wall system came down, then a guy at the get together, he was a master electrician, he just very quickly turned it right side up, put the plate on, and we put it above the exit. Think about that. Now the exit is right side up from the inside of the shipping container that represents the bride. Just try and wrap your brain around that. This is perfection. And all these little deeds he had me do, they're all manifesting right now into absolute mind-bending perfection. That's why I'm freaking out. It's beyond the human brain. This is miracle, a la miracle, a la miracle, 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 and there's more miracles still coming. So see, when the little door opened up at the Ark get together, that's a representation of what I got to see the night I got saved. And guys, I'm telling you, when I walked out that door the night I got saved, when I prayed with Michael, when I prayed Our Father, there's no describing. There's no describing the euphoria and the connection that happened in that moment. It's not even describable. It's not even describable. I can't imagine what's coming. I've been wondering if I would ever get to feel like that again. I was wondering, I wonder if I'll ever experience what it felt like in that moment where the Holy Spirit just came and took over and I was just glowing. I know where y'all are all gonna get to experience it too. Yes. So see, the whole thing that happened to me the night I got saved, with the door being opening and all that, was just a precursor. It was a foreshadowing of the get together at the Ark and the doors opening. And now that door's gonna open and we're gonna fly out of here like doves. Like the Holy Spirit is represented by a dove in the Bible. Do you know why he had me put that silhouette? It's like a shadow of Christ, and the crown of thorns is no longer there. It's a bunch of doves, because for the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross. Where the joy? Setting us free. Woo! Yes, it's so crazy. It doesn't get any cooler than this, you guys. This is so crazy. Okay, let's keep going. Okay, there's a door. Now think about the door and the back of the shipping container at the Ark 20 years later as a representation of that door the night I got saved. It's coming, folks. The door's about to open, and those of us that are in Christ, and those of us that have the key, and we've opened that door's been opened in your heart. Get ready, guys. We're about to see the Lord. Okay, here we go. Ready? Let's keep going. Okay, I want to comment on this right now. Listen very carefully. Even in the scriptures, look how it showed us everything. Now, from the sixth hour, there was darkness over all the land until the ninth hour. Look at the number six. Look at the number nine. Do you get it? They're twins. It's a twin. Even in the numerology, even in the numbers, the six and the nine, you turn a six upside down, it's a nine. So even from the time that Christ was on the cross, it says there was darkness from the sixth hour, because six represents the flesh, the sixth hour to the ninth hour. Do you get it? It's a set of twins. Oh my gosh. That's why Debbie Harry cuts a heart out of her own cake. That's why Marina Abramovic and Debbie Harry make cakes of themselves and cut out their own heart. That represents them eating their own heart, that they're willing to serve Satan instead of serving the Lord. The whole world makes sense now, guys. The whole world makes sense now. Oh my gosh. Here you go. You ready? This is the greatest gift there is. There's no greater gift. That's why, look, there's no greater gift. Why do you think he had me get saved at the St. Anthony Priceless One? It's not, there's nothing that can buy this. Okay, here we go. Let's do it. Let's do it.
Okay, yeah, so we're taking the mirror out of this shipping container because the whole illusion, I think, is about to come down. I mean, so yeah, we're going to take the mirror out. And when we do, I just want to make sure we documented it. And here it comes. All right, you can. Okay, we're almost there. I hope this is cooler than the art gallery in Chinati thing. I hope it's way cooler.
Okay, I want to pause it. Guys, take it out. Look at that exit sign. See, the wall system that was holding the mirror in place was in front of the back door. There was two mirrors in there. One of them got broken in Grand Junction from the transport delivery, and so that one came out, and then that other one stayed in, and that one made it to the Ark. But now the Lord told me, take out the other mirror during the get-together, because I know what it means, because the mirror represents that other reflection, you know, the right side up you, upside down you. So he said, take out the mirror, and when we took out the mirror, that allowed the wall system to come out, and then the exit sign is upside down, but there's a key in the door. Do you get it? This is perfection. I mean, this is perfection in the littlest details. He made sure there was a key in the door instead of a knob you turn, because I'm the guy with the key. I mean, when I was putting that door in, I just put in the smallest, littlest door I could find, because I didn't want to cut a big hole in chunk in the back of that shipping container, and it was just to meet code requirements in San Antonio in case the fire marshal showed up. I could say, yeah, there's an exit in the back, so whatever. And so anyway, yeah, so the Lord made sure even the smallest details. Now the exit sign that's in there, we're taking the mirror out, and the wall system comes down with it, and now the back door will open, and there's a key. And so I unlock the door, and then the Lord tells me, put the silhouette of Christ and all the doves with everybody's prayers on the doves on the back of the container. I actually thought the sculpture, like the silhouette of Christ, was going to go in the judgment seat container inside where there was an empty tomb. That's where I thought I was going to put it. I was just like, I guess that would seem to me where it goes. But no, the Lord wanted it on the outside of the container with the little door open, like the night I got saved. Do you get it? Ah, freak out. I'm freaking out. Dude, this is crazy. Okay, see, the door won't open because this wall system and the exit sign's in front of it. So now when we take all this down, the electrician took this thing off and rewired it. And then we set it up here right side up. Do you understand? Like, within the system that we're in, the Lord gave this guy the key to the kingdom of heaven, the key of David. And so now the exit's been restored to be up, so you know what it is. The twin system. Do you get it? The exit that was upside down and blocked is now right side up and open. Freak out. I just, Lord, I love you. I hope you're not embarrassed. I'm freaking out so bad. Huh. Okay, here we go. Let's do it. Ready? Keep watching. Here we go. This is from the get together, guys. Here we go.
This is supporting it, so God's supporting it. So you grab these guys.
50 seconds, sir.
Yeah, we're good. So here we are, Johnny and Corey, freaking out. We got it loose. This thing's about to come out. I just want to show everybody. There's a key in the back door. There's a key right there. The back door was not it was not possible to open the back door because there was a whole system in front of the exit. The exit was upside down. Now the mirror is coming down and the exit is accessible. We had a master electrician come in and take that down. And when he put it back together, now it's right side up. So now the exit is right side up. And the mirror is coming down. I wonder what the odds are.
And the last bolt was what?
Oh, and the very last bolt to come out of this whole thing, there was only one bolt. It was the very last bolt. It was a hexagon to come out.
I'm going to pause it there because this is really weird. I always use, like, screws are very important to me and what I use for stuff. I must have come up short on a screw, and there was a hex head screw that was very out of place. All the other screws came out with a T25 bit and a couple Phillips heads, but for there to be a hex head as the last screw to get to, that represents the hexagon, like in the pit, you know, like, okay, so I had a little glitch right when I said Lady Gaga, the whole system crashed. I pray to Lord, please. I put so much energy and just so much of my heart and soul into this video. Please, please let it work, please. Sometimes this happens, guys, and the whole thing crashes after doing 2 hours of video. So anyway, Lord, please let this happen. Okay, so anyway, so yeah, so the last screw that came out was a hexagon, and that, you know, like Lady Gaga in the pit. Or I'm sorry, Lady Gaga with her hands on her shoulder, with her hands on her hip. I'm sorry, I gotta slow down. With her hands on her hips, like, you know, the imagery of her. Let's see if I can pull it up. There you go, right here. That's why I was like, wow. And the last one to come out was like an image of, like, Lady Gaga in the pit. Let's see. Let me see if this is gonna. Okay, hang on one sec, guys. Yeah, so the reason I said that about, you know, last bolt was a hexagon because I thought it was weird. Because, see, the hexagon represents the worm that's feeding off us our whole life. And just like Lady Gaga is framing up the hexagon and she's got a bug on her dress. This is reality right here. This is the real world. This is why the Lord called me as a harbinger. This is what the Lord had me uncover. That's why the Victoria Police, in the land down under, their badges, that's an insect coming up out of the ground. See it? That's the eye, antenna. And those are the mandibles, and it's coming out from under the ground. Okay, so anyway, so hopefully this whole thing works, and I'm able to get this thing, like, stitched together. I love you guys. This is the end of the world, guys. Guaranteed. Now, wait, I got about another hour and a half of video here, guys. And I know I'm just, like, freaking out trying to, like, show you every little detail because I want you to know what it all stands for. This is absolute perfection in delivery of information and what the Lord had me do. I mean, he's proving it all right now that everything he had me do was perfection. He did it through me. I'm freaking out. Okay, here we go. Let's do this. Let's keep going. I'm going to play the rest of this video. Let's see what happens.
It was a hexagon to come out. It's insane. I'm going to start just documenting some stuff. I'm going to open up these containers. What a get together. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I don't even know where to start. I'm going to show you something that happened with these containers. So this is what I was told to do. It's what the Lord told me to do. And this container right here, we documented it. There was a mirror that was in it that was there in Grand Junction. And the Lord told me now take the mirror out. And when the mirror came out, it allowed access to the back door. The back door was only in there as a code compliance in San Antonio for the building situation. And anyway, so it was there only for code compliance for building in San Antonio. Sorry about the doggy thing. Anyway, so during the event, this back door got opened right here. That's a very, very new, look how narrow that back door is. Anyway, that's the exit for inside the shipping container. And those are all doves that people put scriptures on. These are, every one of these doves has a scripture on them, and people wrote their favorite scripture on these doves, and we put them here, and it's by the back door, and the back door is now unlocked. There used to be an exit sign that's in there. Sorry. Anyway, that's Philo. He's a sweetie. Anyway, I just want you to look at the representation of that. That's just a silhouette. And all those doves flying away. We know in the Bible the Holy Spirit is represented by a dove. And the Lord put it on my heart to have all these doves leaving, flying away. And the crown of thorns. Someone actually brought a crown of thorns. The crown of thorns that was the crown of thorns is all been turned into doves. Even on the image itself. And it just represents the Holy Spirit leaving this place. Because when the Holy Spirit leaves this place, that's when all hell breaks loose. And that's about to happen, I guarantee it. I absolutely guarantee you that in this world right now, the Lord is about to remove his Spirit from this place. And when that happens, that's just a representation of it. When that happens, all hell is going to break loose. I'm a harbinger, guys. I'm an end of the world harbinger. You either believe that or you don't. All the bombings are printed on the U.S. currency. I'm the guy that the Lord used to show the world all those bombings that are actually printed on the U.S. currency. I was at the FBI showing the FBI. The FBI was going, how in the world did you do this? How did you figure this out? I told them it's a supernatural spiritual gift. I showed them the Twin Towers, the Pentagon, the federal building bombing, and the bombings that are coming that are printed on new currency. All those things have been shown. The Lord sent me to the FBI. I showed them. They were stupefied. One agent was really stupefied. One agent was really pissed off. Anyway, but that represents all the doves flying away. Jesus said, for the joy that was set, the Bible says, for the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross. The joy was us. The joy was setting us free. That's what the joy was. The joy that was set before him, he endured the cross, despising the shame. That back door has been opened now. The mirror's gone out of that thing. That represents the bride of Christ. The bride of Christ is going to leave here, guys. The bride of Christ is about to leave. I don't know when, but I know it's coming. Peace and grace. Your flaws and scars are mine. So far for you. So far for you. And just like that, oh.
Gonna pause it right there. That's what the Lord promised me. The night I got saved, he told me for what I was going to do for him, he would get four people to safety for me. How mind-boggling. Now, without me going down that mental road right now, y'all want to see some just mind-boggling stuff as if you haven't already seen it. I can look at you right now and say, I guarantee you, the Lord God, the creator of all things, has communicated to me that the prophetic utterance that he gave me is about to happen. Now listen, if you pay attention and if you ever heard the prophetic utterance, when it talks about the hand of the oppressor has been lifted against you, and out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind, water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea, and great shall be the destruction of that city. And behold, the abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet, standing in the holy place where it should not be. Here is a mystery made known to you. You are the holy place of which I speak, and the abomination of desolation shall rise within the walls of the temple to destroy the temple. So I'm bearing witness to the destruction of the temple, which is us, the host body system. What are they trying to do? Transhumanism, iron mixed with Marie clay. Right on time, guys. I mean, my brain is just fried. It's just beyond human comprehension what he's allowed me to deliver to you guys with absolute proof. Now, I'm going to take this for a moment, and I'm going to just set this over here, and I'm going to go over here and show you the globalists proclaim transhumanism will eliminate free will and souls as if it's a good thing. Anyway, you can go see all you want on that. This is the video I showed you last night. The end game was in front of us all the time because the Lord showed me these, that what's on the U.S. currency as far back as 2002. I had a website up in 2003 showing the bombings of the federal building, bombing the Twin Towers, the Pentagon, the ones that had already happened. It was called clearpath.com. And then someone came in and scooped up the URL and they forwarded clearpath.com to a mental health site just to be a smartass. But just FYI, so if anyone says they were instrumental in the U.S. currency, you're the guy that solved this is speaking to you right now. And here's the symbology for understanding it. Turning a right-sided up star upside down. That's how they hide their plans, because they inverted us. We're the stars. Do you get it? We're the stars. We got inverted. It's that simple. We're the stars. We're God's princes, the stars. We got inverted. So crazy. Okay, now, let's see. Let me show you something really absolutely insane that happened while this was going on. So, Eli was kind enough to do the little video editing that turned everybody into doves and all that. I'd asked her if she wouldn't mind doing a little segment for the end of that video, and she was kind enough to do it for me. But when she did it, she had put a song that I couldn't keep on there because it would have been a codec violation, and I couldn't use the song. So I kept the imagery. But so I thought, well, I'll just put different music over it. So y'all heard the final countdown, right? Well, in my spirit, I heard the Lord tell me the final countdown. Well, the first thing I thought is, well, if I use that, Lord, I'm going to get a codec violation anyway, the same as if I use the song that Eli had put on there. And she had put, I think, a song by Sia called Unstoppable. And so, but I heard the Lord say final countdown. And so I told Dave the Wave, I said, Dave, why don't you go see if you can find like a cover version of the final countdown to where it won't be a problem, because you can use it and let someone put commercials on your video like I'm going to let them do for this, and they'll get royalties from it. But if you try and use something like Sia, they'll codec you and they'll give you a strike. But someone that just wants to make a little revenue off their, you know, off their remix of the final countdown, who cares? So anyway, so when I went to do that, I saw this. There are very few choices in a remake of the final countdown. Let me show you what happened. Okay, now I want you to listen very closely, please. So while I was trying to find a version of the Final Countdown, which is what the Lord put to me to replace the music that was with the ending of the video you just saw, I went and clicked on YouTube Final Countdown, and then one of the very few choices was this one right here, and I clicked on it. It says Iron Cross. Let me show you. And I'm like, that's crazy. Look, it says the Iron Cross. And it's like in the shape of like a guitar, but it's an upside down cross. And I was just like, okay, that's crazy. A band called Iron Cross, you know, the iron mixed with miry clay. And I'm like, that's crazy. Because the whole thing I showed y'all is that we literally got crucified upside down, the iron mixed with the miry clay. And I was just like, that's crazy. So I'm looking at the Iron Cross, and I just got through telling you guys what's coming on the last video. That's what's coming. That's New York, and then there's New York as well. And that's nukes. That's what's coming. Okay, let me show you how this video starts off from these guys. Watch this. Ready? Let me just kind of ready. Here we go. Hello. Okay, so I just did a video yesterday showing you guys this is what's coming, and now I'm replacing just 1 minute and 27 seconds of audio from a little video that Eli sent me, and I hear Lord say the Final Countdown, and I click on this band called the Iron Cross, and it shows like nukes being launched. Do you think that's kind of weird? That's impossible. Let's take a look at that again. Let's just look at that one more time. Okay, you want to see really weird? Look right behind me on the wall. Okay, you see the launch behind me on the wall? It's probably no big deal. It's probably nothing. Okay. Anyway, yeah, so this video just starts off and it's one launch after another, and before they show the band members, which I'm not going to do. I'm just going to, leave it short and sweet. I mean, I wonder what the odds are. Now, here's where things get even crazier. So I tell Dave, hey, let's just let these guys have royalties off the video that I'm doing. So we checked it, and it's a basic copyright, and they'll get royalties because they'll be able to put commercials on this video. So they'll get some revenue off my video, which is good for them. But you want to see something really crazy? I went to the original YouTube video for Final Countdown, which is a band called Europe, and I clicked on it and I just decided just to watch it. I mean, it's total 80s hair band. And hang on one sec. So I go and I watch right here. I watched Europe right here.
Gear for
Hang on one sec. Okay, so I'm sitting, so I start watching Europe, who is the one that wrote the song. That's the name of the band. And I have them right here on the screen, and I'm watching them, and I see this come up at the 10 second mark. It says 3:40. See, the time is 3:40. And I, as clear as a bell, I heard the Lord say, look up 3:40 in the Bible. Okay, y'all are gonna freak out. Y'all ready? Let's do this, okay? So let me start knocking out some windows here. Let me just start getting rid of some stuff. So let's see, here we go. We don't need this. Let's get rid of that. Let's get rid of this. Let's look at Europe. Okay, there's 340. So it's that's 341. Let me just tell you what happens. At the end of the video, they show the same clock, and it's only changed 1 minute to 341. Just wait. Watch this. Ready? Here we go. Let's do it. Let's start with the 340 at the 10-second mark. There we go. 11-second mark. 340. So let's do Strong's 340. Okay, ready? There it is, 340. Anna Kahinidzo, to renew, I make new again. Anna means up, completing a process. Kahinidzo means to make new, to restore, literally to bring back by renewing. Anna Kenosis. What? Yeah, I was just like, okay, that's crazy. So I watched the whole video, and if you watch this whole video by Europe, you know it's total ladies. And then here at the end of the video, right here, I look. There's the clock again, and it shows 3:41, and I thought that is so strange. It went just 1 minute. And they're making a point, and I heard the Lord say, look up 341 now in the Bible. Ready? So let's look up 341. So I'll go back, and we'll change that to 341. Ready? It means to make new. Again, so I was like, well, that doesn't surprise me. It says to make new again. I renew. I make new again. But it's a little bit different. It's Anna Kaino, right? Anna Kaino. I renew, I make new again. Up as in completing a process. To renew by moving from one stage to a higher, more developed one. And it's in Colossians 3:10. The Lord tells me, go look at Colossians 3:10. And it says, both times referring to God ever transforming the believer by renewing the new man. And I thought, wow, that's fascinating. So I hear the Lord tell me, go to Colossians 3:10. Now, let me ask you a question. How many times have you heard Jonathan Kleck or seen Jonathan Kleck say, his purpose was to make one new man from the two, thus making peace, by inverting the one that's down and then superimposing it with the other one that's in up, and then the two become one in Christ? How many times have you heard that? I told you, if you haven't been inverted and turned up, you're not even saved. That's how you know that you know that you know you've been converted, because you've been turned up. You're on the rock. That's what being on the rock is. That's why in this world, there's bands called the Rolling Stones, because they worship Satan. They know they rolled us because we were living stones. That's why Lucifer walked up and down on the stones in Eden, the fiery stones. Read Ezekiel 28. Thou wast in Eden, thou walkest upon the stones of fire. We're the stones of fire, and we got rolled. Get it? The Rolling Stones. Oh, rock and roll. Oh, I get it. Yeah. Ha, 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 ha. Rolling Stones. Do you ever wonder why in the band, in the album Metamorphosis by the Rolling Stones, they're a bunch of bugs? Because it's freaking true. Ready? You want to see it? Okay, here you go. Ready? Watch. Rolling Stones. Metamorphosis. Metamorphosis album cover. Gee, I wonder why they're all bugs with human masks on. Oh, Now you know the greatest mystery in ever solved. Why do you think Lady Gaga is wearing a dress that's got a bug on it and a serpent? And it shows like an arrow going through her vagina and into the mouth of a bug. Because that arrow, spear tip, represents a penis going in her vagina, which is feeding the bug. Which is exactly what the Catholic Church is, the Vatican. Told you. Woo! Can you say woo? Okay, get ready. It gets better. Here we go. So there you go. Now, so the Lord takes me to, here we go. He takes me to Colossians 3:10. You ready? Y'all want to freak out? Lie not to one another. You know, like 100% no lying. Lie not to one another, seeing that you have put off the old man with his deeds and have put on the new man, which is, ready? There's that number, 341, renewed. It means it's anakahino. It means to renovate, to renew. Isn't it weird that I'm in a house? This house was a pit. It was underwater. There was water 3 feet high in the house. There was a hole knocked in the side of the house just to let the water drain. It was one of the worst houses in the whole neighborhood, and it was such a disaster. I didn't want it. My dad wanted to give it to me, trying to ease his conscience from stealing so much money from me. And I tried to get out of it saying, Dad, it's not even worth $80,000, so no thank you. I said, if you could get it for $60,000 and I could use $20,000 just to fix the electrical and some of the other stuff, because the house is a complete disaster. A couple days later, he said, I got the house for $60,000. What house sells for $60,000? So then I fix this whole place up. Oh, I renovated the whole thing, and it's got Jesus's name on the house out front in red bricks on a background of granite that has metal in it. It's probably no big deal. Anyway, yeah, so let's keep going. So here you go. Having put on the new man, which is renewed, to renovate, and it's from the root ana, which is up, which is, I don't know how many times I've said, you got to get turned up. And then it's also from kahinos, which is to refresh properly with respect to a new age. Well, there you go, because I told you there's a new heavens and a new earth, and I'm the guy that got to tell the whole world it's ready now. So crazy. You ready? Okay. Having put on the new man, which is renewed, 341, which the Lord showed me in a final countdown video by Europe, ready, in knowledge after the image of him that created him. You ready? And having put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge. Ready? In knowledge. Look at what it means. Recognition, that is, by implication, full discernment and acknowledgement after the image of him that created him. So what it's saying is, I've been renewed in the full knowledge and understanding and recognition of the one, the image of him that created me, which is up. Watch. Ready? Everything I've told you is true. Watch. Ready? Okay. Epinosis, recognition, that is full discernment, acknowledgement. See, after the image of him that created him. And the word image means a likeness, a resemblance. Now watch, in the image of him that created him. Ready? Knowledge. Epinosis, it's from 1921, and it's from this one. See, gnosis, which is hinosko, which means, ready, to know absolutely. How many times did I show you? The only way that you know that you know that you know Christ is you got turned up. And what? Here it is. So this is the last piece of gold the Lord God predestined to give me right before the end. He's like, here, Jonathan, everything you told everybody, I'm giving it to you now in the Bible in perfect vocabulary that proves everything I showed you. All glory to God, man. Dude. All glory to the king. Only he could do this. Ready? Okay, let's look at that word. Epigenosko, to know absolutely. But ready? Look at epi. Ready? It means superimposition of time, place, and order as a relation of distribution that is over upon, etc., of rest, at, or of the direction, and with the accusative case, towards or upon, above, among, as long as touching, at, besides, and that have charge of, up. See it right there? Epigenosko, because you've been turned up and you recognize him absolutely. I told you. There it is in the word. There it is in the vocabulary. There it is in the Bible, that you will put off the old man and put on the new in epigenosko. Ready? You know what the word superimposition means? What's superimpose mean? It means to put one image on top of another. Oh, let me give you an example of that. Y'all ready? Okay, let's go to the folders. This is a good place to do that. Let me give you a superimposition. Now remember, we are crucified with Christ. It is no longer I that live, but Christ that lives in me. Let me give you an example. So I went from this, ready? So I went from the old man, come out of the darkness. See, I went from the old man that was upside down. And then, like I was set of twins, and then I was superimposed on Christ getting turned up. That's why he made sure I was even in the position of a crucifixion. And then that becomes us. We get turned up from being our own vampire. We go from this to this. I'm crucified with Christ. I no longer live. Discovery, get it? That's why I was skysurfing with the discovery, because I would discover the truth, which was Christ. And then we all get superimposed onto him. So I don't know if you guys really understand how impossible this all is. It's so insane. Oh, don't say insane, Cleck. You got a better word for it? It was a setup, man. It was just, it was a total massive setup. I'm sorry. It's so crazy. It's so mind-boggling. I feel like I'm on a rocket ship being launched in outer space. Okay. Just give me a second. Okay. Can you imagine ever worrying about anything? Can you imagine worrying that he doesn't have it under control? Anyone that thinks they're trying to control anything has completely lost their mind. Oh. Time out. Happy Onosco. Okay. Oh, sorry, guys. It's just so... anyway, so yeah, no big deal. Oh, shit. Yeah, no big deal. Eleuthera. Yahweh is given a messenger that rings a bell, gathers a church. Keys to the kingdom of heaven, skydiver, vampire sunglasses. I think I have a great idea. It was a setup. It was one heck of a setup. Okay. Hopefully, my inability to just get my shit together right now gives you some kind of an idea of just the magnitude of how profound all this really is. Jesus is as real as it gets. We're the ones that are just like, if you don't understand, he hears every single thing you say. He knows everything you do. He knows every thought you have. If you think for 1 minute the king doesn't know what's going on, you are absolutely insane. Anyway, and for all you false prophet hunters, I'm going to tell you this. I love you in Christ. I'm so sorry. I pray for each one of you that God doesn't hold any of it against you, because I don't. God have mercy on you. You just got your ass handed to you by Satan. That's all. Anyway, and I pray for you. I forgive you, and I hope God. I hope you haven't blasphemed the Holy Spirit, because, yeah, everything the Lord's had me do, He had me do through the Spirit of the Living God. So He operated through me. I didn't draw the pit. I didn't do the artwork. He did the artwork through me. It wasn't me sky surfing. It was Him sky surfing through me. I mean, it's like, woo. That's one heck of a setup, right? Now there's a white horse out in my driveway. It's probably no big deal. I think I'll start driving around with my bow in the car or something. Okay, guys. Oh. All right. Did y'all catch all that? Did you understand that you want to talk about actualization? I prayed and I said, I pray that before I leave this place, you somehow I am actualized, and I know absolutely that every single thing that you've had me do somehow is right. And here's how he does it, right on the verge of the very end of it all. It's so crazy. So anyway, so now remember, it's a double-edged sword. As hard as I'm laughing will be as hard as I cry for the rest of the world. It's just, there's not, you can't escape it. There's not one without the other. All glory to God. I just want to tell Jesus, I love you, and thank you for putting up with me. I mean, thank you for never kicking me to the curb, for putting up with just my lack of just sometimes even my own lack of belief, or to ever have doubted anything. I know that we might all face a moment where it looks super duper scary, but you know what? Having done this video and getting to show everybody everything that you've shown me, I mean, really, you took me to a Final Countdown video to show me the last nugget of absolute truth for the ministry, Epihanosko, put on the new man to supervise. Okay, let me show you some guys. There's a video that I have up here. I wanted to show you guys. Look, and right here, it's called the third short superimposition film. And if you want to see a great little understanding of what it means to like superimposition and juxtaposition, I'll leave this link. I don't want to play it just because I don't want to get a, you know what? Anyway, you know what? I don't want to play it. I'll just put it in the description box, but or you know, I'll put it as a link in the folder, in the ARC folder. But guys, here's the deal, man. We are about to leave this place. These guys, Lady Gaga and all these guys, this is what's taking over. It's an insect race. The female host body was used as a trap so a de demonic spirit could form a twin system with God's angels in order to destroy God's angels because they're too powerful. You can't bring down God's angels. You have to trick them into the forbidden fruit. That's the deal. The whole system is twin. It's cannibalistic. That's why there is a kid called Cain and one called Abel. It's a cannibalistic system. That's why even the number 6 and 9, six, male and female, one right side up, one upside down, male and female energies. That's why you see like Vampire Academy, V and A. The A should be crossed, but it's not because they're making the point. Vampire Academy, male and female. Here's Debbie Harry cutting out her own heart, you know, with her friend Marina Abramovic. So they make a cake of themselves, naked cake of themselves. She cuts out her own heart and eats it to symbolize she sold out to that side. It's a complete twin system. It's a no-brainer now. Cain and Abel, Jacob and Esau, it all bears witness. Everything I've told you has been true, has been correct. Just like the clothing line, Lurking Class, this has its own twin image. You just turn it. That's death. Death is like the Grim Reaper. Death is this other race of beings. The other race of beings is an insect race. That's why even a pair of boxer shorts, it shows death coming out of a crack, like coming out of the pit. It all got started with the penis. That's what started it. Eve, the fall was Eve, and then she was impregnated by the serpent race. Then Adam impregnated her, and she had heteropaternal super fecundation twins. And when you turn this over, you turn these boxers over, it's an insect coming out, because that's what comes out of the pit in the end of the world. That's no different than why the Vatican has this guy right here in a slave collar with twin fetuses. Look, there it is, watch. Twin fetuses, a twin here, one here, and one here. The slave collar becomes the beast because that's the beast system. And when you turn this guy upside down, he becomes a locust from the pit. Every single thing the Lord's let me show you is true. And he made sure that I even lived out a representation of it. That's why there's a V with fangs on the side of my truck. That used to be the logo for Vlad Eyewear. There's Johnny with a V with fangs on, falling out of the sky, and that's a representation of what happened to us. And then there's a right side up triangle on my truck, and that represents crucified with Christ. And so we're all in a twin system, and unless you get your evil twin reconciled to God, then you still have a line that goes to the pit that's feeding a locust that's going to eat you the second you die and you go to the pit. Your soul is consumed by a locust, and you get assimilated into their group, and the mystery of everything is solved. Okay, I'm going to take a moment and just try and wrap my brain around all this and just, you know, pray for the world. It's time to pray for the people all over the world, not just the Ukraine. I mean everybody. The entire world's about to die right now. The entire earth. All humanity. All people. Unless you're converted, you're not leaving here. Unless you've been inverted, you're not leaving. You'll be put to the test. That's what the Great Tribulation is. It's a big test. It says experiment of good or evil. What will you do when you're under pressure? Will you turn to evil? Or are you willing to risk? Are you willing to die like I was the night I got saved? A lot of people say, "Oh, I'm a believer. I'll die for Christ." If that's not really true, God knows it's not true, and you'll be put to the test. If you're willing to die for Christ, you got nothing to worry about. Anyway, so I've been put to the test, not just the night I got saved. I've been put to the test over and over. There's even an attempted kidnapping guy waiting here trying to do a snatch and grab on me one day. So I've been put to the test, man, over and over and over again. I could give a rip. Oh, please don't kill me so I go home. Oh, no. It's like, whatever. Okay, but, you know, you might get to go where you go before, so just saying. Anyway, so there it is. There it is. It's all been solved. It's solved. Epigenosko. I love you guys. I mean that. I love you in Christ. I understand for the joy that was set before him. Getting to meet you guys and hug you guys and everybody become tangible. You know, I mean, I did this because, in my spirit, all I wanted to do was please the Lord. I knew that he had promised me something. I knew he was good for it. And then it became my love was to help others, to see others get better, to see others, you know, not suffer, to see others come out of the trap. I mean, that's all I want. I just want everyone to be okay. That's my heart. And that was my heart as a little kid. And then you grow up and then the monster gets a hold of you. And it starts with, think about it. It all starts around puberty, right? Because just like it says in James, there's a war going on in your members. It doesn't mean your group of buddies. It means your members. So, you know, it's like that's what's running you. So anyway, the mystery is solved. Okay, now I'm just going to chill out and try and, you know, just process. I hope you watch this video a couple times. And I hope you thank God. You thank Jesus for what he did. Don't thank me. Thank Jesus. He purposed me for what I'm doing, but he's the one that purposed me, and he's the one that went to the cross for you, not me. I mean, I will, you know, agreed. Yes, I did grind it out, but it was my joy to get to grind it out for you guys, as well as for my children, as well as just for Jesus. I want to please my Lord. I want him to be happy with me. That's it. Instead of me wanting what I wanted, I don't care about that anymore. It means nothing. All right. I love you guys. Now, here's another thing. I don't know how, you know, if we got, I don't know if we have a day left. I don't know if we have a week or a month, but I know we're done. This proves it. Everything in the last 48 hours proves it. But the whole get together and the whole getting everything ready for the ark was a whopper. For just me pushing financially out. So anyway, if you can support the ministry, only if you are well suited to do it. If you're, you know, the Bible says in the end, they'll throw their gold and their silver in the street. Guys, when there's no natural resources, there's no more food, no more trucks delivering food, there's no food on the grocery store shelves, when that happens, money's worthless. It's worthless. So if you're holding on to a really big bank thinking that's going to help you, I can assure you it's not. Because as you can already see, once the whole thing begins, things are going to dry up super quick. It's, you know, it'd probably be smart for anyone and everyone just to have a little bank at home, just a little bit, you know, don't leave all your money electronically. And then if you're well equipped to help support this ministry a little bit, it would be nice, because I still support a lot of other people. And so it takes the burden off me. Anyway, I'm not worried about it. It always happens. The Lord always takes care of everything that I need. And right now I'm okay, but it's getting pretty, you know, the coffers are getting very, very low. That's all I'll say. That's just a good way of saying it. Okay, so anyway, the white horse is out front. The mystery of all mysteries is solved. It's a twin system. It's a cannibalistic system. Think of even the earth as like an egg, like a female egg. Think of the electricity that came, like I beheld Satan as lightning from heaven. Think of like, boom. Just think of the angels as the energy that fuels the system. I mean, everything's like a microcosm of itself. It's so fascinating. It is so unbelievably fascinating. It is so mind-boggling to get to be in a host body and to get to know what the Lord's let me show you guys. The Vatican is a serpent wearing a crown. The mouth of the serpent is a vagina. That is a... Now listen, nothing against females. It doesn't matter if you're male or female. It's the system. It's the whole system, the host body system, the forbidden fruit. So that's why children of God, the angels, you have the ability to choose. You could never love God without free will. Did you know that? And the only way I love God is because I know he loved me first. Do you understand? So otherwise you'd be a robot, and that's what they're trying to do to the rest of the world. Make you serve Satan. You will do what I say. It's like, dude, whatever. It's like, whatever. Okay. Anyway, but see, they Satan tries to control everybody with fear. Faith just destroys fear. That's why I'm so excited that all the things he had me do in faith have proven out to be true right before your eyes today. Balak was a snake. It's like, okay, look at all the folders. I mean, you can't argue with it. Here, let me show you a couple pictures. Watch this. So look, so here's like, you know, here's their little t-shirt, like, shut the F up. STFU. Like, see, vampiric system, they know it. See, this is a lurking class. Look, that's like the virgin, but it's death. And it's also, look, if you look at it like this, that's an insect coming out of a dimension. And it's also a vagina. Okay, and then look, here's a girl's dress. That's a bug. That's the eye of an insect eye. Those are the mandibles, like a bee. Look, broken promises. It's what's inside that counts. So the girl is really a rubber skin suit. So see, all the things that I've told you, they're all true. And now the invisible world that no one can see, you can see clearly. That's why, look, Lady Gaga, she picked the name Gaga is 7171. The word God, the number 7171 is from Jeremiah, and destruction cometh from the north. It's Egypt was a very fair heifer. It means a female. So Egypt is represented as a beautiful woman, you know, the bait. Get it? But destruction, Gaga, cometh. And the word Gaga means a biting insect. I mean, why do you think she's got an insect on her dress? I mean, duh. See the insect right here? You see the serpent down here? You see the spear going through right here, the tip of the spear through her vagina into the mouth of the insect, because that's what feeds the insects. That's exactly what the Vatican is. It's the same exact thing. Let me show you the Vatican one time, because I want to just make sure I put it in this video. One time I'll just show you the Vatican. Watch this. It's the same thing as Lady Gaga's dress, so it's a no-brainer now. I mean, there's no way to convolute this. There's no way to get this wrong because I've got all the evidence now. The Lord God himself handed it to me. He gave me a gift that's so mind-boggling that it's a confirming witness to the Bible. So here you go. Here it is. So here's the largest altar in the world. It's a dead sheep. So see the sheep right here? There's the nut. Just see right here. See that part? There's that part. See the eye? There's the eye. See the other eye? There's the eye. So the whole thing's a dead sheep, but the seed becomes a penis, ejaculating a seed right there. And when you turn that whole thing upside down, well, before you turn it upside down, look, there's the penis. That's why all these angels are melting into semen. I told you. Everything's right, guys. The whole thing's been proven out now. Ready? Watch. I'm waiting for that to enlarge. There you go. There you go. See, it's all these angels melting into semen. Now, what's calling the angels down? Look at all these, like, grown women. It's like all these naked women calling the little angels down. Come on down. So that turns into a dead sheep. And then here's the penis ejaculating all the angels melting into semen. Okay, now watch. Now we just simply take that altar, just like I showed you, male and female, right side up and upside down. So male's right side up. There you go. Watch. Male, right side up. Then we take the whole sheep right here, and we just put it right here, and we invert it, and the whole thing becomes the female reproductive system. One right side up, one upside down. The whole system is cannibalistic, and it's no matter what, it ends in self-cannibalization. Every world. Everyone. But see, God, the Lord God, El, the Almighty God, is willing to give his angels free will. That's how we all exist. Do you understand? And then without free will, we couldn't love God. I love Jesus. I fear the Lord. I fear the Lord. But I love the Lord. I love the Lord so much. I love Jesus so much. But I fear the Lord, because he did all of this. It's like, yeah. So Elohim is Genesis 1. Let us make man in our image. Vain show, representative figure, especially an idol. So here's Genesis 1. Here's the formation of the male and female system, which Satan owns the flesh. So right here is the formation of the system of the flesh. It's male and female. There it is. So there's the penis. You turn it upside down, it's the female reproductive system. And right there on the outside of the building, that is the mouth of the serpent. So what does the serpent eat? Well, the serpent eats whatever goes in it. Okay, well, check it out. All you got to do is zoom out and it becomes a bug. That's why Lady Gaga's got a bug on her dress. The serpent feeds the insect race on in the other dimension called the pit, which hell, you go into the eternal abyss. So your soul is translated to the pit and you have your own, your eye that went with you everywhere your whole life that didn't get disconnected. It holds a record against you. You're consumed by your own locust. That's why the Bible says, I'll restore the years the cankerworm has eaten, because every year of your life, you're being fed off by a worm in the pit. This is perfection. Okay, now, I spit it all out. I'm just going to take a minute. And then I may try and just come do just hardcore data videos with all this information. Just, you know, kind of like a lawyer in a court of law. Like, can you tell me why this is a, is this altar a large bug? It's a yes or no answer. Yes, it is. Why is it a bug? Because we really erase the bugs and we eat souls. Who's the king of all the locusts from the pit? Says it right there in Revelation 9:11. Oh, 9:11. Why do you think they bombed the Twin Towers on 9/11? Do you see how everything in the world makes sense now? Everything in the world makes sense. So they're rolling in World War III. They're going to nuke New York. They're going to bring down the whole system. Satan's going to roll it out. Death, doom, and destruction. Here it comes. It's here. Okay, now I'm just going to take a breath. Lord, I hope I did all right on that. Sorry about this. I mean, it's hard not to laugh your ass off because you did such an amazing job of just mind-blowing perfection. And wow. Okay. Y'all see it? Okay. Anyway, there it is. Everything I showed you is true. And again, the female host body is just like, wow. I mean, you know, that's what got us, got a whole bunch of us in a whole lot of trouble. That's why it's a forbidden fruit. And now you know why people come up to me and say, hey, Johnny, I drew a picture of you, because our souls are being hunted through the host body system. That's why there's a dead sheep behind my ear here that Alex drew, because that dead sheep is the same exact thing as the largest altar in the world, which is a dead sheep, which is inside of a serpent. That's why when I said, hey, Alex, why'd you do the dead sheep? He went, do you know who you're speaking with? And I said, yeah, do you know who you're speaking with? I'm a servant of the Most High. All glory to God. All right, guys, I'm going to wrap this up. I'm going to, hopefully this part adds to the hour I already got and there's no issues. Oh, Lord, please, please. I would hate to have to redo this. I don't know if I could do it. It's like freak out. Oh, yay. Oh, the volume's on. It's like, oh, wow, I had the volume off the whole time. That would suck. All right, I love you guys. How cool is this? Huh? Is it time for a hug? Where's my bear? My bear is missing. Hang on, guys. Stay here. I've got to go grab my bear. Pause. All right, all right, all right. We're good. This is you. Oh, by the way, it was so nice to meet you guys. I really enjoyed getting to jump from one person to the next, hugging all you guys. Someone left a comment, one of the comments in the video, that they were really upset. They said they'd driven a long way and his wife needed deliverance from alcoholism. And he said, I seem more concerned with my artwork than with the people. I was like, wow, really? What a crazy statement to make. The art project was about all the people, by the way. And if someone has like an alcoholism problem, it's not that you lay hands on them and it gives them deliverance. They have to make a choice to either serve the Lord or serve themselves. So if that helps at all, There you go. But I can assure you that if someone was there because of alcoholism, it's not that I'm just going to lay my hands on someone that has alcoholism and they'll be okay. That's a choice that someone can make, and they can turn to God and say, look, help me turn from this. I had to ask the Lord to help me turn from some stuff, and no one came and just laid hands on me. I had to say, Lord Jesus, help me. So it comes from inside of them, not from me. So just so you know. All right. So anyway, look, guys, I love you in Christ. This represents y'all. I got to hug a whole bunch of you. I think I got to hug probably everyone that wanted a hug. I hope so. Your doves are up on the wall. Hey, Robert, I've got your dove here. And I'll be there in a couple of days. I'll put your dove up. I'll take a picture for you. Anyway, you don't have to have a dove on the sculpture to be leaving here at all. But, you know, it's just kind of cool, right, to have your own prayer on a dove representing that's the word that is part of your heart. You know what mine is now? Mine is Psalm 27, all of it. Because when I was forsaken by my mom and my dad, and I was walking down that street, I was so lonely. I was so broken and I just could not believe what was going on. And I looked up, and the Lord made sure I looked up and saw Psalm 27. Praise God. Though your mother and father will forsake you, I will pick you up and set you upon a rock. I'll take that way over anything else, even if it came with all the suffering it took to get it. And it did. All glory to the King, Yeshua, Jesus, Yeshua. We love you. We love you. I love you. I love you. I am not ashamed to call you my Lord and my Savior. And I pray that the boat is ready to go instantly, because I just don't want to see any more suffering here. All right, guys. Here's another bear hug from Johnny. I love you guys. Grab your pillow and hug your pillow back. All right. Peace and grace. And watch this video a couple times. Try and wrap your brain around that slideshow. And then Colossians and how the Lord delivered it on the final countdown. So crazy. All right, guys. Take care. Good night.